try doing it like a M Shadows from Avenged Sevenfold, where you just... Yeah. What's wrong with you? Cody.
Hey! Hey, guys.
Were you sleeping?
I was taking a nap before the show started. I'm sorry, I'm back now. How's it going? I'm happy to be here.
Are you?
I'm totally wide awake.
Okay.
Thrilled.
For those of you who are not watching us on video, Cody was...
I was napping.
Just napping.
I was napping a little bit.
Brian's over there with his donger mic. What's up, Brian?
Look at that thing. Oh, man.
How's it going?
Still looks fantastic.
You doing good?
Sounds pretty good, though, right?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, sounds good. Yeah. And then we got Ace in studio. What's up, Ace?
Hello.
Yeah.
Ace.
Hey.
I know.
How's it going, man?
Going good, man. Yeah. First time here.
You're the... Because RB3's been on the show twice, once on video, but you are the first guest other than RB3 that's actually...
How does that feel? How does that feel?
Yeah, it feels
good,
man.
You'll take it. You're going to accept
it. I'll take it. I'll take it.
All right. Well,
I like how we both went to the same time. We're like, shit, someone needs to
talk. You go first, and then I'll go. Okay. All right, so Ace, you're in the Wanger studio right now.
Yeah.
For those, a lot of people cannot see on the other side, but there's so many, like, dildos and just dick drawings just on the other side. Because it's, you know, we got to get in the Wanger mood.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. It was definitely something I noticed when I first walked in. But
it blends in sometimes, but it's good that you
I got used to it.
Yeah,
I got used to it pretty quick.
Some are bigger, some are smaller. I mean, you know, you got to have a variety.
And then you got Beardo's mic, too.
Exactly, yeah. I mean,
it goes with the whole vibe.
It's 2017, dude. We got to have a diversity of dicks just in the studio.
Hashtag diversity of dicks. How's it going, Brian? How you doing?
I'm good. How you guys doing?
Yeah, we're doing all right.
Sound good? Everything sound good?
Everything sounds good. This is the first time we're actually recording today. We didn't record before and cut.
We did not do a test run that sounded like shit. That's not what happened at all. Yeah.
You went to school for this, right?
No.
Oh, okay. You should have.
I think you called him out on that last week, too. But
did he?
He said that he didn't go to school for this.
Hey, man. He's a one-man army.
He's a one-man army.
He seems like he would have gone to school for this, though.
No, I took one class, and I was like, you know what? I like it.
I got this.
I'm going to do this. I don't need any more.
You arrogant prick.
They're like, you should take the advanced course. I'm like, no, thank you.
That's like taking 3 years of Spanish. You're like, nah, I'm good with two. I'm good with two.
Do you guys remember anything from Spanish?
No.
I mean, unless you grew up speaking it,
but I mean,
I was a native speaker and I still took Spanish class because why not?
How was that for you?
It was cool because
that was a good one. All right,
I didn't mean to do that either.
Great. All right,
I did ace it. We took tests and my teacher was like, "Yeah, you got 100% again." So
my dad, she doesn't like pick up on that. She's like, "Do you speak this? Like, did you grow up?"
No,
like, I mean it's not like a fault. Yeah. It's just like, hey,
yeah. A lot of people got on my back about it because they were not native Spanish speakers, and they were like, "That's not fair." And I'm like, "I want to learn how to read it better and write better."
Yeah, that's good.
My dad was the same way. My dad took like all 4 years of Spanish, and by the time he was in his fourth year, he was like writing essays in Spanish.
Yeah,
so like,
it helps just to have a little refresher when it comes to, you know.
I could barely get the English language down. I can't even. Second language is, you know.
It's a little bit difficult.
It is.
Yeah. Ace, whenever you do something cool, you have to say aced it. From now on,
you're aced it. Or if you review stuff, you start a YouTube channel, it's like, I give this thing. Don't do that. But I just say, I aced it. Yeah.
And freeze frame, like, you know.
Before we get into a whole... A lot of shenanigans for this show because you know we've got so much planned.
We have literally nothing planned. We're gonna see how this goes.
Yeah, no, we got some good stuff.
Okay.
I want to bring up some stuff.
Okay.
But last week I said that we were going to be giving away a free Wanger shirt. Is all you had to do was just leave a comment on the video, which by the way, last week's episode got up to 2,000 views.
Shit ton of comments too. Yeah,
and a lot of comments.
Thank you.
A lot of likes. We really appreciate it. We appreciate the support. It seems like
what are you laughing at over there, Brian?
What are you laughing at?
What were you thanking our fans? Being very grateful, and you're over here just giggling like a freaking child.
I should have played the horns at that point. But
I was waiting for you. While we were clapping here, this really sad two-person clap, I was like, you know, we should have the
Oh, that's
the
right, you do sound bites.
But I thought it would have been funny to have like a delayed horn.
It's all right, we'll put
it... laughed at your joke before you even did it?
We'll put the horns in post. How about that? Yeah, we'll put it in for it. Oh, okay, there it is. Jesus Christ. So we are choosing a comment right now, but also, just to let you know, we are also giving away another Wanger shirt. I think every single week we're just going to give away a free Wanger shirt until I run out of money. Okay? So because it's all for you guys. We really appreciate the support. Maybe sometime we get some Blu-rays. We'll get some other giveaways. Maybe we'll give away a jug of water that Ace had drank and all
We should have done that
today. That would be great. We could all sign it.
Yeah, we could all sign it.
Yeah.
I think we could.
This is an official Ace jug of water that he drank from.
Yes.
And it's like halfway
put
finished.
Put your face on there. You're just like.
Yeah, man.
Ace's water.
Aced it.
Which I do have somewhere. It's hidden somewhere right now.
Aced Springs.
Before I announce the winner of the t-shirt, I wanted to like I wanted to have a bunch of jugs of water and just surprise you. Just
like, we got you covered,
but
buddy.
I just production value. I didn't have that. The winner of last week's giveaway for the Wanger shirt, which again you can choose pretty much any type of shirt that you would like. You know, don't kill me, don't or anything like that. But because they vary in prices. But Andrew Peterson, congratulations. Your comment was, "The Wanger Show is the best podcast on this channel. This group of guys are amazing." These group of guys, it's okay. Listen, they're amazing to listen to, and I'm glad to call myself a Wanger follower. Wanger for life from Minnesota. So Andrew Peterson, cool. Please contact me Twitter at Copser15. Give me an address, and I'll come find you. No. I will send you a t-shirt. I promise. And maybe I'll try to find you, too. But so congratulations. And then again, if you're watching this episode, whether you're brand new or if you're continuously watching it from previous episodes, we are on video now, so it's a lot more exciting. So all you got to do is whatever conversation we're having all throughout the episode, just leave a comment and we will choose a winner based off of that. So yeah, make us laugh.
Yeah, what are you looking in a comment?
You know, something like that comment was very nice. There's other comments in here that were very funny. I think this week I was going for a nice comment, you know, some positive feedback. Next week, you know, leave a funny comment.
Make us laugh.
The funniest comment. There were some funny comments in here too, but I wanted to go for the nice one.
But from the show, like mention something from the show so we know they watch.
Yes. Yeah. Sure. Not just like, I want a t-shirt, which was funny. Those make me laugh all the time. Chuckle. I appreciate it. And I think one day I'll just choose one. If you make me laugh hard enough, like give me a shirt, you freak. You know?
You fucking assholes.
You fucking prick.
Don't do that. It's not
you
nice.
You dumb piece of shit.
Anyway, Ace, what is your favorite type of water?
Oh, right away.
Segwaying. I need to get to, because I was going to ask, because we're talking about is Ace water.
Yeah.
And I didn't want to interrupt the giveaway there.
Yeah. Well,
are you an Arrowhead guy?
No, you know what's funny, man? I do drink Arrowhead. Okay. But I don't think that's necessarily... I think we've talked about this before.
You got a top 10 rankings?
No, the reason why I get the Arrowhead is because it actually has a handle for you to drain.
That's right.
The jug
I remember talking about this.
Yeah, we did, because there's other ones that just have a string.
The freaking crystal guy's
and
the
it's
one
like,
is insane.
How am I supposed to drink this gallon of water with a string
still
that's
heard
holding
that
it? So
I tried.
Okay. Yeah, I don't have a preference when it comes to taste.
Okay.
I mean,
really?
I mean,
really?
Spring water.
I figured as a water connoisseur like yourself.
See, I'm not a water connoisseur.
You have a lot of water.
He's like Waterboy. He's got the little jar from like Alaska, just like pure water.
No, spring water.
Do you have water that you can't stand?
No.
Trying to get you to say you don't like Awkwafina, because I fucking hate
really?
Awkwafina with a passion. Awkwafina is good for like the first 10 seconds. Once it gets remotely warm, it tastes like plastic, and it's horrible.
Dasani is horrible.
Dasani's not good either.
I don't like Dasani. Because I know some people are like, oh, water's all the same. No. I mean, come on. Fiji? No.
It's not.
Fiji is straight from
the Fiji's
like,
good.
Fiji's
it's a little
straight
overrated,
from the
but it is pretty good.
You guys drink smart water? You ever tried
smart
water? Smart
water's pretty good. Don't make it any smart, but it's pretty good.
Yeah. It's okay.
Why do you give like a...
Because that's overrated as well, and they sell in a giant bottle like they're fucking compensating for something.
As long as you're not
so
drinking
great.
Out of, as long as you're not drinking Voss water, I think you're fine.
Oh yeah,
Voss water is like, oh fuck you, dude.
Is that the one that's like a cylinder with like a little?
Man. Probably comes with a lemon on the side too. Like you fucking jerk.
Gives you like a bowl of fruit to go with.
A fedora hat on the side. And it's like, oh, we get it.
And like a fake mustache. Bullshit like that.
Bro, they don't do any. I'm probably offending a lot of people that drink Voss water, but you know,
as they're watching this show,
as they're watching,
brought to you by our sponsor Voss.
Voss
here. Thank you for that.
Yeah, but it's always, and it's expensive too. Smart water is expensive. Voss water is expensive. The ones I get are just like $2. And I'm like, all right, that's as much as I'm willing to pay.
Now, okay, here's the thing. I think we might have asked you this off air, but for on air purposes, do you buy a whole, like, is there like a big giant case of jugs that you get, or you just have to get them individually?
I get a few gallons of water, and then at work we have like the refill.
Oh, you just
water.
Refill it?
Yeah,
oh,
just refill
go.
It a few times because I know everyone's like, "Well, that's not safe," and you know, I know it's not safe if to keep you know like a plastic jug of water for such a long time.
Yeah,
so
but you do it like a
rotate
week,
it every few days and keep it clean. Keep it
How
fine.
Does that grocery store trip go when you have to carry like you know?
It's jugs. Pretty nuts, man.
How many
so,
trips back to the car do you have to take?
It's quite.
They
a lot.
Have carts.
No, I'm saying when he's unloading it.
Yeah,
because
when you put
he has
them
a
all,
cart.
Yeah, he has put a cart. The carts, and then in order to put him back to my apartment, I'm like, I'm not strong enough to carry all
do
these.
You go to, do you go to Target for that?
Yeah, Target.
Target? Yeah, Target. That's the best.
Yeah.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. Where do you guys do your grocery store shopping?
I'm all over. I mean, there's a Ralph's right here. I have a Ralph's cart.
You haven't
so
settled on a place yet?
No, well, it just depends, because the other day I was making tacos, and I went to Ralph's, and I was like, oh, I have meat. And I was like, oh, shit, I don't have meat. So then I went to Vaughn's here, and they had, like, nothing. I'm like, what the f-? They just,
really?
It was like
just
a
shit together, Vaughn's.
I think it might have been a holiday weekend, so I don't know. They were clearing out on meat. So then I had to go back to Ralph's. But and then I like going to Target as well. It just depends on how I'm feeling that day. You know what I'm saying?
Target's one of the happiest places ever. I find myself going there at least once a week now. I hate myself for doing it, but it's great deals.
Everything you see here, Target. It's all fucking Target. Yeah.
Yeah. There's even another sponsor opportunity right there.
Yeah. Target. Hey, call us. Hit us up, bro.
No, there's a Target right across from where I live. So just by default and by location, I just go to Target. It's right there. So.
It's good. Yeah, it's good. Hey, Brian, do me a favor. Tweet out the number.
I will tweet out the number.
Thank you. This isn't live, but you know, we like to have people call in.
Yeah, if you guys ever, you're like, how do I call into the show? Follow us on Twitter.
Just follow us on Twitter.
We usually, I'll retweet his or do a quote tweet, have something smirky and not funny at all.
Yeah.
And then we'll talk to you guys.
We'll talk to him. Yeah, we'll talk some shit, talk some hits. Bits hits.
Some hits?
Sure.
And bits hits.
Some hits. Nice. Speaking of hits, I don't know if you guys listen to Blink-182, but Blink-182 came out with a new
solid
song.
Solid segue right there.
Yeah, thank you. Appreciate that. Well, all you got to do, I think the key to segue is just speaking of which.
Okay.
And then you go do it.
No, you like that.
I think so. You like water? Speaking of which, Netflix has been killing it. a brand new Blink-182 song came out, and I approve.
Yeah,
I very much approve.
Too. Ace probably doesn't care at all.
No,
I'm glad that we have him on the show for this.
I've listened to a few songs from Blink-182.
Are you playing it? Well, could we get in trouble for that?
This could be a copyright claim.
Yeah.
Let's go ahead and stop it.
Yeah,
after
10
seconds.
Right
there. Hey, yeah. 3 seconds.
Yeah. We have a call right now.
Oh. We have a call already? Jesus.
443. I don't know who 443 is.
Oh, boy. Who do we got?
443.
We got a caller on the Wanger Show. We're talking Blink-182. If you're not a fan, then fuck us. What do you want to talk about?
Hey, what's up, guys? It's your boy, Chris Woodburn again.
Woodburn. What's up, buddy? How you doing?
Just chilling, watching a 40-year-old virgin on MTV.
Solid story
film.
Of my
Solid
life.
Film
That's
right
what's
there.
Up.
Yeah, buddy. All right.
Yeah. I fuck with Blink-182, but a question I meant to ask you guys last week, but a little swept up in the moment.
That's all good, man. Brian's an asshole. He probably hung up on you.
All right. So we can all agree that up to this point, the DCU has been divisive. I really liked Man of Steel. BVS and Suicide Squad. I did like those movies. I was quite disappointed with them. Now, this year, we got Wonder Woman and Justice League.
Yeah, buddy.
If those films are, again, divisive, will there be any hope for the DCU?
No. I don't think so.
I think Warner Brothers might be so, paranoid, they might just reboot it, honestly. If it doesn't, if they do what BVS and Suicide Squad did, where it's like, controversial and shit. I know they've gotten far. I could see them backing out and be like, oh shit, just throw it all away.
They've made enough money though where they must be doing something right, because Suicide Squad weighed 700 million worldwide.
That's the thing though. That's what makes me worried about, is that even if the movies are somewhat mediocre, they'll still keep going as long as they make money.
Here's the thing though, because that's very true, but I still feel like it's potential money loss more than potential money won, because for BVS could have been the higher than
a billion dollar movie.
It still made a shit ton of money.
It made a lot, but if it was an actually well received, critically acclaimed film as far as Rotten Tomatoes goes, then it would have received $1 billion and it would have made more money, which is why I do feel like a reboot is a possibility.
And here's the thing though, if they reboot it, do you think fans are just going to be fed up at that point? Would you even want to bother? Really? You're going to restart it all after all this?
It all goes down to the characters, though, because the characters are so timeless, which is why it's frustrating as far as why are they getting these characters wrong? It's Batman, Superman, and Wonder Woman. These are the most iconic characters in all of comic books, and yet we can't get it right.
It should be a home run each time.
Yes.
You have Batman.
It doesn't even have to be a home run each time, because every Marvel movie,
a solid double. Get a double of it.
Yeah, just get on base.
What you gotta do.
All you gotta do is get
a run. Move a run in.
I know you love Doctor Strange.
Steal a base.
I know we're comparing, but fuck it. That's at this point you have to. I know you really love Doctor Strange. I thought it was just an okay movie, but it's not terrible. It's cohesive. You know, you didn't have three editors go in there and have three different cuts, and there's no extended cut. You know what I mean? Ooh. It's just, trust the people that don't listen to the fucking fans. Stop listening. Don't even listen to us, what we're talking about. Just do your thing. That's all. Okay. Listen to that. Yeah. Do your thing. Don't, the other, everything else, don't listen to us. But I don't know. Yeah. They're just so aware of everything that's going on. They're in their own head.
I think unless there's like a complete shakeup in Warner Brothers with like the executives and stuff, they're still going to be on the same track.
Yeah.
I feel like the DC Warner Brothers studio is way, way, way too hands-on when it comes to the directors, which is why so many directors have dropped down, which is why even Ben Affleck was like, dude, I'll act in your movie, I'll play Batman, but I'm not going to put my name as a director on this.
I don't even think he's going to last that long. I mean, no, I don't know. I don't know now with him, you know, being coming out and saying he's in rehab and stuff. It might be better. It might be better in his favor, but who knows?
But I feel like that's a great purpose, or not to say excuse, but almost excuse for him to be like, this is why I can't be Batman anymore.
Yeah.
Even though it's like part of the reason why is because he knows it sucks.
Yeah. So, I mean, look, I want these movies to be good. Yeah. I really do. But it's just, bleh.
Yeah.
And the thing that is incredibly frustrating that I'm trying to wrap my head around, you know, we had the Dark Knight trilogy, which I love.
Mm-hmm.
Warner Brothers, they let Nolan do his thing, and that it was great. But now, you know, take Ben Affleck. All right, Live by Night, withstanding, the dude has won an Oscar, and they're, you know, meddling in what, and you know all the directors that have left Flash, you know, Wonder Woman's coming out with Patty Jenkins, but Michelle McLaren left before her. Why are they interfering with all those directors, but they stayed out of the way when Nolan was, you know, running things? I mean, I love Nolan, but let these other filmmakers make their films. It makes no sense to me.
It's a combination of a lot of things. It's, first of all, when Nolan's films were going on, the Marvel cinema, like the whole universe trend, hadn't fully launched yet. That launched the same year as Dark Knight. Dark Knight came out in what, 2008? Same thing with Iron Man?
Iron Man and Dark Knight came out the same year.
The whole idea and the concept of a cinematic universe wasn't really fully established, because even Marvel was testing the waters with that. And even there, they had a rocky start too, because the first Iron Man was great. Incredible Hulk was okay. It didn't do well that great at the box office. And Iron Man 2, I think, did better at the box office, but still the movie was just kind of I think as soon as that first Avengers movie hit, they're like, okay, we have something on our hands. And then they got better and better and better. And then Warner Brothers, what they should have been doing is maybe planning that as the Dark Knight trilogy was going on, like, hey, this universe thing might be something. Let's maybe for the future, after Dark Knight Rises comes out, maybe let's plan something to start setting up the universe. And then, because I think when Man of Steel came out, they didn't have that in mind, because Man of Steel is very much like on its own. And then by the time they started to develop things, it felt a little too late.
Yeah,
so,
like, they pitched Man of Steel as their new Dark Knight type thing, where they weren't really thinking about universe building. You know, like, because Nolan and Goyer were developing that one the same way they did Dark Knight. So it's just, it makes sense to where they're like, oh, fuck, we didn't think about this universe shit.
Yeah.
Let's make a universe. You know,
it's like, and now they're throwing it kind of just out there, you know, in hopes that it would work. And now it's just like, you know, I don't mind them. I don't mind them doing it differently, because, you know, Justice League is coming out fairly quickly in comparison to like when the Avengers came out and building up to it. It's fine. You can do it your own way. It's just the way they've been going about it. It's like, you're not writing interesting characters for characters that are interesting. You know, I don't care about a lot of the people that are actually in these movies. And that was one of the reasons why you hook on to other movies. And even like the X-Men franchise, like, you care for those characters. And I guess technically they started the whole cinematic universe before anybody else did. It's still all of their characters, but I think they've done it pretty successfully.
Here's the thing about the DC characters too, is the fact that these DC movies are just taking kind of fun moments and not making cohesive films and not making cohesive stories.
Right.
Which is why I feel like Justice League is going to be a mess.
It scares me.
It's going to be really like, oh, that really cool scene where Aquaman punches something. And then, oh, that really cool scene where Batman does a backflip on it. Like, it's just going to be cool scenes, but not an actual movie. Like, that's what I feel like it's going to be. At least everything I've seen from, like, that BTS video made me feel like that's what it is.
Mm.
We just see them all posing, and then they pose again, and then they pose again.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, it's just one Zack Snyder, you know, crazy action fest.
Yeah. And even Wonder Woman hasn't really sold me. Like, the last trailer that came out, I was like, okay, that's okay, cool. I think now I get the idea what they're going for. The first few trailers were just like, it just looks like another,
I feel like Wonder Woman's gonna be the one kind of, because everyone wants it to do good. Everyone's like, please, Wonder
please
Woman,
for the love of God,
please
be good.
Be good. So I feel like they're almost kind of gonna hypnotize themselves into thinking, well, at least it wasn't Suicide Squad.
Yeah.
So here's a 80% on Rotten Tomatoes. I mean, it could be because of the fact that everyone wants it to be good.
Yeah.
So
There you go, Chris. Thank you for the question. That was our DCEU stuff, man.
One other quick thing. Do you think that it's at all possible, you know, that Warner Brothers could get Chris Nolan somehow involved?
No. I think he's done.
He's probably done.
He doesn't want to.
I
applaud him for doing that. Like, he wants to go out and do his own thing. He doesn't want to be known for just making DC movies.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Because that's the thing. Like he's done his superhero thing, and not to say like he's too good to do more movies, but it's just like that's, you know, he wants to go off and do his space sci-fi movies. He wants to go off and do his war movies. You know, Nolan reminds me a lot of Kubrick in a way.
Yeah, sure.
Because he dabbles into different genres. I've yet to see him do a comedy or a horror. I'd like to see that. That'd be very interesting for him.
Inception was originally pitched as a horror. When he was originally developing it, like long before it came out, before it came out. Like he originally envisioned it as a horror film.
Oh, that's cool. Okay. All right.
And also, everything will get compared to The Dark Knight.
Yeah,
that's true. If he does do superhero stuff,
he's made his staple in the superhero game. He doesn't. He really doesn't. Everyone always talks about The Dark Knight. It's in every single conversation when it comes about superhero movies. And if like that's just a mic drop, you don't need to go back to it. Why go back? There's no point, you know. So, all right, Chris, thank you so much, man. Thanks for calling in, buddy.
All right, and hey, Cody, could you help me out with the Twitter questions with Wendy? It's tough getting them picked these days.
I'll pass the word along, dude. I'll pass it along.
And I hope you guys played my little soundbite from last week, you know, about, you know, fuck the haters on the internet.
We'll save that.
I'd love for all of them to hear that. All
right, man. I'll save that for you.
All right, buddy. Keep fighting the fight, brother.
See you, man.
Thank you, Chris.
All right. Peace.
See you.
All righty. Yeah, that's good talk, man. Good DCU stuff, man.
Yeah.
It's always up in the air. It's always talking about DC, man.
I was going to say, you guys get it a lot more because you guys are, you know, full-time at Collider, so that means
it's like
you hear
much
all
every,
these
every
topics.
Every main story on Movie
every
Talk.
Day. Yeah, so by the time I want to talk about it with you guys are like, yeah, dude, it's fine.
Well, unfortunately, like, I don't talk about sit in on the Movie Talk stuff all the time because I'm off doing other things, but, you know, I don't mind talking about it, but, yeah, that's all it is now. That's the biggest, if we were like...
It's what people want to talk about. Yeah. So we'll talk about it,
And I don't mind it, so... But what do you guys want to talk about now?
We have another call. If you want to take another call or do you want to wait?
Yeah, let's do it. Why not? We have anything else to talk about.
It's open.
We got someone on the phone right now. This is the Wanger Show. Welcome. Who do we got?
Hey, guys. It's Copster's least favorite caller.
Oh.
Yeah.
What up, Sarah? You're not my least favorite caller. Why are you saying that?
Second least.
Second.
I have a feeling. I get a vibe.
No, there's no vibe. Come on, Sarah. We're good, huh? We're good, right? We good, right, girl?
We don't have beef, do we?
They're not good.
No, we're not good?
You guys are not
good. We got beef?
I'm saying we don't have a beef, do we?
No, of course not.
You're fine. You're fine. What do you want to talk about today, Sarah?
Not much to talk about. I just saw Beauty and the Beast yesterday. I want to know if you guys saw it. What are your thoughts?
Anybody see it here?
I haven't seen it.
We are so prepared.
Wow.
But I'm probably going to go see it today.
I think I might see it.
I'm that guy who's probably going to go watch Beauty and the Beast. Yeah.
I do want to see it.
I like watching movies on Sunday nights. Actually.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Like Sundays nice are good.
Sundays are good for twofers.
No, twofers. Yeah.
Or a triple threat. You ever done a triple threat?
I have not done a triple
threat. Sarah, have you ever done a triple threat? Do you know what that is?
I did do a triple threat once.
Ooh. What were the three movies that you saw?
Well, I've done it in theaters once. It was three not great movies, but it was a fun day. It was, let me think. It was When in Rome, Valentine's Day, and I think the third one was Dear John.
Sarah.
It's like a torture of just romance.
Sarah, why you putting yourself through that?
It was a girls' day.
Okay.
It was
high school. We were having fun. We didn't like any of the movies, but they were fun.
Okay. Yeah, there you go.
Good experience.
Like, the next one will be better. We're going to try Dear John now.
Dear John's going to be the one.
Yeah, exactly.
Dear John wasn't that bad.
Is that Channing Tatum?
I didn't see that.
I don't remember. I don't know why I saw that movie.
Wait, Cody.
One of the better Nicholas Buckley.
Yeah.
Are you taking your fiance to Beauty and the Beast?
Or yeah, probably.
Cool. Yeah. I feel like everyone who's going to Beauty and the Beast somehow has, every friend of mine has been like, oh, I'm taking my girlfriend, I'm taking my fiance, and I'm like, cool.
Ace, there is no shame with you going by yourself.
No, there's no shame.
No,
no shame.
So
of course not.
Beauty and the Beast has a Disney movies. I love the Disney animated movies. So for me, it's like, I'm cool with going by myself.
Yeah.
So I'm totally going to do it.
Sarah, what did you think about Beauty and the Beast?
It was really good. I did see it by myself, and I loved it.
It's the best way to see a movie.
I was a little mixed on Emma Watson at some point.
I say it ain't so.
I've heard some things about her and her singing.
Interesting.
That they did something with her voice that I'm like, oh.
There definitely was some auto-tune.
Yeah.
Super obvious at points.
Like T-Pain?
That's exactly what happened.
That's a shame.
I kind of look forward to this
I don't know. Hopefully it's not too obvious, but I'm okay with it. I mean, she's, I don't know.
You would think she would be the best part of the movie.
Yeah.
Like, I keep hearing Luke Evans is the best part. I don't know if that's true.
Oh, Luke Evans and Josh Gad. Yeah. Every time they came on, they just stole everything.
That's awesome.
All right.
It's good to hear.
I've always liked Luke Evans. Luke Evans to me, he's always been a solid actor that he does good in everything he is. And so
it's true. Better or worse than Cinderella?
Better.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
All right.
I
enjoyed Cinderella. I haven't gone back and rewatched it since I saw it in theaters. But okay.
I've only seen it once, but I liked it.
All right. Alrighty. Cool. You want to ask us another question before we let you go?
Yeah. I mean, you guys brought it up, but I have a lot of friends who are mixed on the whole watching movies alone in theaters. I mean, they think it's kind of weird. I personally think it's a lot of fun. Just it's kind of like having someone look over your shoulder when you're reading a book, you know? Mm-hmm. I like going alone. So what do you guys think?
Same thing.
It's the best, too, when you go like in the middle of the day and you're literally the only one in the theater.
Oh, dude.
That's really freaking cool.
I saw Whiplash really late in the game, but I was the only person in the theater watching Whiplash. And I'm just like...
Guys,
like I had no one to express to, but it was such a great experience.
In those situations, I was always afraid, like if you're the last one in the theater on the last show, they would like shut it off because they don't know that you're there. Because we did that sometimes when I worked in the theater.
Oh no!
Whenever there's no one in there, we shut the theater off. Yeah,
Ryan, what about you? You like
I'm trying to hear what's going on with the phone?
I think she's listening to some music in the background there.
Is it like EDM
laundry,
or something?
Something going on. Sarah, are you playing some music?
Oh, yeah. Sorry. I'm doing laundry while I talk.
I called it.
Nice. Okay. All right. No, that's understandable.
Sorry. I can turn it off for a second.
Guess that sound.
That's okay. All
right. No, but I saw The Master by myself.
I didn't realize you guys could hear it.
That was all good.
The Master?
Yeah. The Joaquin Phoenix, Paul Thomas Anderson movie.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I went like during
that
the
movie
day.
Is a fucking trip.
It is. I enjoyed it until the very end. It kind of just ended.
Ellis has like the best line about that movie on his review. He had said like, I don't know what was going on, but I appreciated it.
Yeah.
Like, I just like I appreciate everything that's happening right now.
Yeah, like it was so well done. The acting was fucking phenomenal.
Mm-hmm.
But then you're like, why did I watch this? What's going on?
It's a Scientology commentary. Like, what's going on?
But
what
it's not
you?
Like completely shitting on it.
No.
But it's just like... showing you it.
I see a lot of movies by myself. Mm-hmm. I usually go when my buddies can't make it, I usually just go see the movie by myself. Like I recently saw Get Out by myself holy crap, that was freaking awesome. Mm-hmm.
Did you at least have a crowd during that movie?
No, because I went like during like a Saturday night. Mm-hmm. So it was a packed, completely sold out screening.
Mm-hmm.
And the whole crowd kind of had like this moment of like unity.
Mm-hmm.
We were all just screaming for like Chris and we're like, Chris!
That was a fun theater experience.
It's such a freaking good movie to see with the crowd.
Have you seen it yet, Copsy?
I still have not seen
it. God damn it.
I'm very busy.
Do you even like movies?
I haven't seen it either.
I like movies, but it's so hard to go to movies.
Wait a minute. Is Ace there?
Yeah. Oh, that's right.
We probably should have let off with that.
Ace is here. Yeah, that's right.
Hi, Sarah.
I forget we're not like live or anything like that.
Hi.
We're trying to keep the guest rotation going. We had RB3 on last week. We got Ace on. I'm pretty sure we're going to have Perry on next time, so that'll be fun. So we just want to switch things up.
Oh, man, if I knew Ace was there, I would have asked him this Avatar question I've been dying to ask.
Oh,
Sarah.
Well, we're at a time. We got to get to the next caller. No, go ahead. Ask away.
All right. Well, sorry?
No, go ahead. Ask away.
Okay. So, a quick question. By the way, Ace, I thought your appearance on a TV talk when you mentioned that miniseries, ever since I heard that, I've been like dying to see it. And I was like, so like, whenever those other panelists were like, I don't know what you're talking about, I'm like, what is there not to get? It's awesome.
Yeah. I went crazy on TV fights.
TV fights.
Crazy enough to muster up a win. And I just went full nerd rage. So
for Avatar?
Yeah. I love every second of it.
Last Airbender series?
Yeah, I did. Yeah. So, what'd you think of it?
So, well, I had a different question. So, a lot of people I know want a reboot of the Last Airbender film, which I get. I don't think it would make a great movie just because that first season focuses so much on world building and character building. There's not much of a strong narrative to it. But I think season one of Legend of Korra, it's only 13 episodes. It's so well written and so tight. And there's like one really strong villain. I think if they were to just cut out all the fat, you know, cut out that love triangle and those bending games, I think it would make a really cool movie.
It's funny because people have brought this up before and I've said the exact same thing, where it's like with Game of Thrones, it's like saying let's make Game of Thrones a movie, right? It's way too much to put into a movie, which is why we make it into a show. But you're right, Korra is different because Korra can be, you know, one of those things where you make it a compelling movie, you have a strong female character, you have amazing action, and you have a combination of so many great things that can be put into this film. So that for me is what can be an awesome film.
Nice. What do you, by the way, just out of curiosity, what do you prefer, Airbender or Korra?
It has to be Avatar The Last Airbender. Korra is great and I love Korra, but Korra is always going to be, you know, a spin-off series of it's definitely two different things. But I do feel like,
agree completely,
if I have to put them together and I have to compare the both of them, I would say Avatar slightly because of the full story that it encapsulates with the characters that we get.
I agree. I agree entirely.
I've heard these shows. Took the words right out of my mouth. No, it's good to talk.
I've been dying to talk to Ace about this.
This is how you do it. Yeah.
Well, let you guys go. Brian, Cody, and I will we'll go away.
But before, one more thing. I just want to say that last Snow's No Show was awesome.
Oh, thank you so much. Yeah, thank you. Did you like Brett's freak out?
And Don't Be a Weirdo, that last episode was great.
I got one fan.
There you go.
Yeah.
Did you enjoy Brett's freak out on the show?
Oh, that was amazing.
Yeah, I
like. I want to hear his You Mean Dupree joke, but
I'm sure it'll come one day, and I'm sure more freakouts from Brett will be happening.
I hope so. All right, well, thanks for taking my call again, guys. You guys are the best.
You're the best, Sarah.
Thank you so much.
Bye, Sarah.
Bye-bye.
All right, bye.
Awesome.
Sarah's the best. She calls in every week. Great sport.
So thanks, Sarah. Appreciate you. Speaking of animated shows, I've been watching Death Note.
Yeah.
I know. I got you into it.
You got me into it. It's the one anime that I got you into.
Well, because it's like, I was talking with him about it, because I'm trying to convince him to watch it now.
Yeah.
What are you laughing at?
I'm still laughing.
Okay. No, no. Just,
something else. It feels like,
out of all the anime shows, it feels the least like over the top or kind of extreme. Because it feels the least
anime of all the anime.
Yeah, yeah. It feels very grounded in a weird way.
You don't like when people go like, and lose their minds.
There's even some parts in Death Note that are a little like extreme, anime. but I can get past it.
Sure.
But it like the story is so interesting.
The story's amazing.
It's very interesting. And the antagonist and protagonist, their back and forth is so freaking intriguing.
Yeah.
And it just really makes me hate one side over the other. And I've been really enjoying it.
It really is, like I said on the show, it's the greatest cat and mouse game I've seen in fiction. It's one of those things where I saw that too, Cody.
What is that? I don't know.
It's like a guy next to
Twitter.
A boob.
JT retweeted it.
Oh, okay.
Awesome.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah. But it really is like...
I thought you meant the homeless man. Sorry.
These two geniuses going back and forth and trying to one-up each other. And it's so freaking good.
Yeah.
And it does have, like, the underlying theme of it is, like, this horrific, supernatural, weird, creepy theme.
Mm-hmm.
And at the same time, it's also, like, this detective kind of, like, cop, but back and forth. Like, like detective Sherlock Holmes kind of thing.
A little noirish, noirish.
Yeah.
Film noir.
It's great, man.
Yeah, I like it a lot.
Did you guys ever play L.A. Noir?
No.
Fun game.
Did not.
All right, that's my contribution for this segment, guys. All right.
I wanted to. I really did.
It's fun. I think it got a bad rap. It's a good time.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember just hearing the ending. I was like, oh, fuck, that's dark.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's pretty dark.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I know they wanted to do more of those, I think.
There were rumors about it. I think they're just moving
on.
We big video game guys?
We play a lot of video games?
I used to. I used to be like a gamer, like, dude, but not as much as
now.
What's
your game, your go-to game?
I do a lot of FPS. Okay. I have first-person shooters.
Cody hates those.
I know he does. And I think I've talked about this to you because I was the Call of Duty guy. So I'm probably that guy you hate. Yeah, that's me. I'm that guy you hate, dude.
No, I mean, I used to play them all the time, too. I got bored of them. You know,
I love Call of Duty.
When there's ones like where there's no story or the story's like,
oh, like,
you know,
like every
4 hours
game?
Long.
Will you
let me finish my thought? Because I was
going
to say,
every single year?
As I make this point, which I make to you every fucking time.
Are you a FIFA guy?
No. Now you threw me off. I'm pissed off at you. Every time me and Cobb talk about this, I'm like, look, I have no one to talk. I buy Madden every year. I play NBA 2K17. Like I have no one to talk.
Oh, they can shift a lot cooler than the last year.
Yeah, I saw you playing that last time, and yeah. There was actually like a career mode to it. Like
you hear that? There's a story mode on NBA 2K17.
Where you become a criminal and you beat your wife, and then you beat up dogs and stuff.
Damn, that went dark.
No? That went dark pretty quickly. No, you have an NBA career, and you got to break up.
Oh,
with NBA,
I thought you were talking about Madden. Like no. Football, because football players are criminals.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Every single one of them.
And not every single one, but there's a lot of criminals.
No.
But NBA 2K1, you're in your apartment, and you're like training
yeah.
and
you
shit.
You got a loft and shit with a court. And
oh, that's kind
of
cool.
Yeah, there's like, you go to a barbershop. Speaking of which, my hair fucking sucks.
Oh, we'll get to that in a second. I wanted to get to that in a second, because I did go to a...
Before I was interrupted, I was just saying, I get kind of bored with first-person shooters. Okay. You know, now I can't make this argument without, you know... What are you laughing at over there, you fucking asshole?
I was wondering if you like the hair that you
have. Oh, no.
Have.
We're talking about video games.
Okay.
Talking about video games.
Yeah.
So when exactly do you go to boot camp for the Army?
What? Oh, next week. Next week I enlist. Yeah. It's gonna be fun.
So there's a career mode.
I'm not talking about this anymore.
Hold on.
I'm pretty sure we close this.
You can create your own character, right?
Are you talking about the basketball game?
Yes.
Yes.
So do you make yourself your height or just like a you but a taller?
No, I made myself like 5'7". I was a point guard. I didn't pretend to be like a 7'5", you know, center. What are you laughing at, Brian?
Why would you make yourself realistic in the game?
Because you gotta have some integrity with this.
Dude, I remember playing MLB 2004 with Pujols on the front. I think mm-hmm. Pujols was, when he was on the he was on the Cardinals. Mm-hmm. I remember making my team because I was in a travel ball league at the time, and I would make all of our players on our team, but I would put all their stats to 100.
Oh yeah,
and it's just
that
like
too.
I played like
one
runs. I put like one game and it just wasn't even fun.
I would trade for A-Rod and like Vladimir Guerrero to have everyone on the same fucking team. Yeah, mm-hmm. I remember that.
It's fun stuff. I remember playing baseball games in the past. I played FIFA a couple times. My buddies were huge on FIFA.
FIFA was like a huge thing for a couple of my friends. They mm-hmm. always played FIFA. But a game that I played when I was younger, when I was really, really into the WWE, was the WWE games mm-hmm. where you can like make your
like
own character.
SmackDown?
Yes.
Which one?
Here Comes the Pain.
Yes.
There was that one. Know Your Role, I think what it was.
Dude.
Or Shut Your Mouth.
Okay.
I forget what it was.
Here Comes the Pain is one of the... I was always really good at that game. Mm-hmm. That's the one that Brock Lesnar was on the cover
of.
Yes.
Those are always fun because the career mode, like no one ever, I think they still do it this way, where no one ever says anything. So you just see the subtitles
or
whatever they're talking.
Yeah.
That game was the shit.
That game was fun, man.
I played it once.
Yeah.
Wait, what system was that on?
PlayStation 2. I had PS2.
Oh, PS2. Yeah. I remember playing
Gamecast.
The N64 one where the No Mercy was awesome.
Yeah.
WWF No Mercy and WWF SmackDown versus Raw was awesome.
Yes.
Yeah. Or WrestleMania 2000. Yeah. Awesome game.
Which WrestleMania? I had one for the GameCube that was WrestleMania, but it was fucking difficult. Oh my God, I remember this now. Yeah, the WrestleMania, like the career mode was so hard, but you start out getting like the shit kicked out of you by Vince McMahon's goons. And like you almost die and you have to fight your way back up to the WWE.
I think
I honestly might have remembered
that because I there was a brief period where I watched it, when The Rock, Goldberg, Steve Austin, Triple H, they were all kind of up and coming and stuff like that. But those are the only names that I can throw out there for wrestling.
You did your best there.
I did my best. Thanks, babe.
Yeah.
I
was really into it when I was younger.
Okay.
Like really, really.
I'm only asking because Mass Effect Andromeda comes out really soon.
Oh
yeah. I'm very excited.
You heard the buzz though?
I'm hearing that some bad things. About
I heard
it.
It's bad.
Oh, that's what fucking scares me. Don't say it. I follow about Jake Baldino, who used to do pretty much it. He does his Game Ranks channel, which is like the number one gaming channel that I go to and watch all my stuff.
Crazy how that happened. Yeah.
Oh, dude, they do.
I remember subscribing when it was
stuff.
Like right when he first started it. He's like, "Hey guys, starting up a new channel."
Yeah, they're great. Check out Game Ranks. They do a lot of great stuff. And then pretty much it too. Eric does a lot of cool stuff.
His reviews are awesome.
Very interesting stuff. He does post trailer reactions, so he doesn't watch trailers at all. He's the reason why I don't watch trailers, and he'll watch a movie then go back and watch the trailer as a post reaction and see what was spoiled in the movie. It's really cool. And then he does his reviews that he does are fucking so cool. He'll do this thing where he's like talking to himself while reviewing the movie. One will be like kind of pro the movie, one will be con the movie, and it's fucking awesome. It's
That's
really
cool.
interesting.
There's a guy who was bowling and talked about Split.
Yeah.
I was like, why is this guy bowling?
Because it's a fucking cool
it's
idea.
He's having a conversation with somebody.
Why aren't you bowling,
what
Brian?
What are you doing,
what,
Brian?
What, do you want to sit in front of a camera and generic and fucking green screen? Come on.
Like, why does he have to be bowling? It's so distracting when he's talking about the movie.
Because it's something interesting.
It's
something interesting to do.
It's supposed to show, like, having a conversation
with somebody
else.
I get that.
Out.
But it's with himself.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that's the idea.
That's the...
It's like, okay.
I don't get it.
Okay,
you're the friend.
Fuck
you're
you,
stupid.
Brian.
I don't get
Here,
it.
Here, it's like,
I don't get
when
it.
You're seeing a movie, you're fighting yourself like, oh, was that good? Was that not good? That's the whole idea.
I don't fight. I know what I like, and I know what I don't like.
Because you're weird when you watch movies. You don't like
your opinion's so absolute. Like, yeah. No, guys. Yeah. I'm the one.
I saw his Twitter the other day, and he was talking about some movie. Like, Sasha had replied to you on something. I don't know what movie you guys were talking about. And then I saw you reply to another guy. You're like, oh, yeah, it was so predictable. Apparently, every fucking movie is predictable to you because you're so smart.
First of all, it wasn't a movie. It was Porto's.
It was the food place.
It was food.
Oh, it was food? Oh, I just imagined.
I think he did that as a joke. That was part of the joke, making fun of himself.
No okay. one got the joke.
I got it. I didn't reply to it, but I got it.
It took me a minute, but I did get it.
I said my first time trying Porto's, I liked it 9 out of 10.
And it got, oh shit! I didn't know Porto's was. I thought it was like a show or something.
No.
I think I said like grilled chicken sandwich or some shit.
I thought that was a show too.
So then
it's
a guy
a good show A&E every Thursday.
A guy replied back saying, "This is Logan all over again." So I made the joke. I said, "It's predictable."
I saw that part.
End of the meal was gonna. So that was fun. And then Sasha's like, "You don't like Porto's?" Mm. And I was like, "I gave it a 9 out of 10." Mm-hmm. Like, what the fuck? I don't know how to...
What the fuck?
I don't know what to do
but
anymore.
Yeah, but what's the one point missing, dude?
What's wrong with it, Brian?
What's wrong with
Why do you hate it so much?
It was a little dry.
Oh, okay. All right. No, that's fine. Well, speaking of which, though, I made a tweet last week about the fucking Venom movie being announced.
Oh,
so this Venom movie was announced, and I, of course, jokingly tweeted, bring back Topher Grace, # Venom. Mm. And so many fucking people were like, what the fuck? You fucking stupid, bro. Are you serious?
Fucking
really,
stupid, bro?
Really? Go to Fresh and Easy, douche. You know, like just
Fresh
so many.
And easy, huh?
Fresh and Easy is really good. But so many people took that shit.
Go to Fresh and Easy.
So many people. I'm gonna go back and read.
Go to Stater Brothers.
Hold on. So many people freaking took that shit. So freaking. Yeah. Oh, did you see the new Dark Tower poster?
Oh, no.
It looks really cool. Good. It looks really good. Hold on, I'm gonna find
They're actually gonna have that release in July? They're going for it?
Fuck, I hope so.
I was thinking they might delay it, but
these people are like, this guy's like, are you fucking kidding me? Oh no, that guy was joking. Let me see, hold on. Let me see. It was all the quote tweets that people were like freaking out about. I really hope it's a joke, dude.
That's like me when
put that thing back where it came from, or so help me. I mean, but then there was some like, oh, best joke of 2017. So I appreciate that. But
why are they making a Venom movie though?
I don't know.
What studio is making it?
It's Sony.
It's Sony.
Oh, okay.
They originally planned this when they were doing the Amazing Spider-Man films as a sort of like spin-off that would tie back in. But it's like you can't have Venom without Spider-Man. So it's
no,
like
you can't. And
like,
not
that's
just
the whole
that,
idea.
But the fact that Venom is a villain, and I know in the new comics, it's like Venom's kind of an anti-hero.
Well, yeah,
now.
Isn't it like
yeah,
he's like
but
a
he's,
superhero kind?
He
like he's
sucks
like a, he's like an assassin or something. He uses guns and shit.
It's not cool. Venom has always been cool because he's the polar opposite of Spider-Man. He's the antithesis of Spider-Man. So that's what made
good word.
Him cool.
That's a good word right there. Antithesis.
He's the reason. Like I like the fact that he would always like not be able to use his spider sense against him.
Mm-hmm.
That he was always like using everything he loved against him and trying to take Mary Jane away from him. That was what made Venom cool.
Did they ever team up, Spider-Man and Venom?
Yeah, they teamed up against Carnage.
Carnage, right? Yeah, I do remember. I remember the cartoons,
the animated series.
Right?
Yeah.
That's the most thing I know about. Sorry, I burped and I didn't want to do it on the mic. Yeah,
still heard it.
Oh, God. Ugh. You see that? No, I'm just joking. There's nothing down there. That's the most I know about Spider-Man is the animated series.
Yeah.
And I remember that storyline of Carnage coming into it. It was just...
Yeah, I mean, cool. He's not like this pure evil, you know, like Carnage where he just wants to kill people for fun. But at the same time, he's not an anti-hero whatsoever.
Hey, Brian, why'd you giggle and smile while Ace is giving a solid argument here about the characteristics of Venom?
Every time you say pure, I just think of Split now.
Oh, God damn.
Your heart is pure. Rejoice.
We have a caller on the line right now.
We'll wait on him. Hold on. I want to talk about this fucking Venom thing. Cody, you're a big Spider-Man guy.
Yeah, I was going to say you are, right? No?
I'm really not. I just look like the guy. Like, I watch the show, you know, and I like the movies, but,
how about the
movie doesn't make sense.
How about that Spider-Man game coming out this year, though?
Oh, yeah, I heard about
that. Cool.
It looks
like
really,
fun.
Really
oh,
freaking cool.
Like
as long as they bring back the Spider-Man 2 open world
Ooh,
sort of thing.
Yeah.
Spider-Man 2, I hate when they make video games after movies, like, when they're identical, but
that
holy
one was
shit.
Fun.
That one was, like, one of the best ones. Seriously.
I love the ridiculous fan theory about life being the actual prequel to Venom or whatever.
Film,
like, I went down such a rabbit hole, like, looking at evidence of that. And it's so stupid because it was made by different studios and then it was picked up by Sony. So it wasn't even, like, a legit Sony
I mean,
movie.
If that were true,
but,
it'd be cool. But then again, it's like, why are you spoiling it?
Yeah, if it was true, I'd be so mad
that
I found out about it online.
Does that come out this weekend or is that next weekend?
No, it comes out this
weekend. The 24th.
It's out.
Yeah.
Same
as Power Rangers.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
That's the noises you make when you talk about.
That's what I make. God damn it! I was so. Joel spoiled something for me. Don't say it. It's really not a big spoiler.
I was going to say, it's not that big of a spoiler.
It is, but it isn't. Because I didn't think they were going to do it. And the fact that...
yeah.
Do you want to talk to our caller?
Yeah, let's do it. Fuck it.
Caller, you're on the line.
Caller, you're on the line.
Hey,
who do we have?
What's up? Alex Marzonia.
Hey, Alex.
What's up, dude? We just saw you yesterday. I was drinking a beer.
I did. Nice to talk to you guys again.
Yeah, welcome. And for those of you who don't know, Alex, when we had segments on the show.
Back when we used to be organized on the show.
He did the W2F News, and then he also did, there was another song he did.
That is the WTF.
No, wasn't there another
movie
one,
news.
Though?
He did movie news.
Yeah, that's right. He made that with his fingers, music. So we appreciate that, man.
With my fingers. Mm-hmm.
What do you
I'm
want?
Glad you guys still play it. Oh,
yeah. Come on. Come on. Do we have it? Do we have
I'll
it somewhere?
Find it. I'll find it.
Right, Cody's going to find
love
it.
You guys.
For those of you who don't know, Alex is in a band. Are you still in a band?
Yes, I am.
And what is the name of that band?
That name is Surface Streets.
Surface Streets.
Don't take the freeway.
Hey.
The Surface Streets.
There you go.
Hey.
Are you guys playing anytime soon? Do you guys play venues a lot?
Not in a while, but we're looking for dates this summer.
Okay. All right.
You guys got a Facebook page?
So I'll let you guys know.
Yeah, plug up your guys' Facebook and Twitter and all that.
What's up?
Plug your guys' social media, Surface Streets.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Just look us up, Surface Streets Music, on Facebook, SoundCloud, Bandcamp, all that good stuff.
Got it.
Boom. And you'll find us.
Boom. Like, go, everyone check out Surface Streets and check them out.
He's got good taste in music, man. We talk about this all the time. Whenever,
hell yeah.
Whenever I hang out with the guy.
If you ever need someone to shoot a music video, you got your crew here.
There we go.
We'll shoot you a music video. That'd be fun.
That'd be so awesome.
Alex, are you excited for Power Rangers?
Hang up on him. Movie coming out? Oh my God.
I'm just joking. Well, what would you
it's
like
funny
to talk?
Like,
no, go ahead.
Oh, no, I was just saying, like, I don't remember Power Rangers all that well. I remember watching it in my living room when I was like 3 or 4.
Same thing.
And just like jumping around and pretending to be a Power Ranger.
Yeah.
I don't remember anything like...
Why is that funny?
I don't remember like any of the plot lines or whatever.
Oh.
You act I'll like have you. Plot lines.
I'll have you. I'll have you. No. No. No, there was fucking plot lines. What are you talking about, Ryan?
Yeah, remember
Shut up, Bachelor.
The magical purple goo.
Yeah.
Oh, man. That was riveting
Ivan
stuff.
That was the movie, not the TV show.
I know.
I recently watched the movie again.
It's so bad. It's
pretty
good.
Dumb.
But it's amazing how dumb it is, though.
Yeah, but like the graphics are so bad.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
Like a PS2 game, mm-hmm. like yeah. on a movie screen.
Yep. Mm-hmm. It's pretty funny. I mean, when they're doing backflips and talking to each other normally, that's right behind you, Kimberly. That's just it's too good.
No, but when like they knee him in the balls when like at the very end of push him into the comet.
Yeah, that's how they defeat
him. I'm sorry.
Him.
How else would you do it? That's how you're gonna subdue your villain.
Ryan,
why does he have balls?
This is a dark and gritty movie that has realistic ways of defeating.
When he's like a giant robot, he's like, let me add my balls in there too, so it's like, so I can get hit in them and hurt.
Hey, Transformers had robot testicles.
That's true. That is very
true. Why are you bagging on Power Rangers?
You know, honestly,
point made.
Everything that I've been seeing about this first Power Rangers movie reminds me a lot of when I saw all the stuff for the first Transformers movie.
Yeah.
It looks kind of in the same vein. And if it's like that first movie, I'm fine with it because I can tolerate that movie out of the other ones in the franchise. I mean, I've talked to people that have seen it. They say they like it. People that have grown up Power Rangers fans, they said, I think if you're a genuine Power Rangers fan like myself, like I've actually gone back and rewatched a lot of the old episodes. It's not that very easy to do because they're a lot of the same thing. It's a lot of the same
recycled footage.
It's recycled footage. When the Zords are forming up and stuff like that. But the storylines, it's always like, you know, oh, someone's having a bad day today. Oh, they get kidnapped. Oh, they got to fight the monsters. Oh, they got to form up and do their Zords. And then, you know, they defeat the villain and that's it. But they have cool kind of story arcs that go in, like when the Green Ranger comes in, they have like a couple episodes that are on their own little series. Like if you ever want to go back and rewatch them, just watch those, like, watch the very first episode because it's the shit. Watch Zach's birthday when he fights his badass Black Knight. I remember having that one on VHS. I watched that one a lot. It's awesome. And then watch a lot of the part 1, part 2, part 3 episodes of Power Rangers. And then, you know, there you go. You don't have to go. Yeah, there it is. All yeah, right. So I'm very much looking forward
to it.
Talk
about the guy who killed his roommate with a sword?
That was Tommy. Tommy.
No. It was one of the later Power Rangers. Oh, yeah. It wasn't the original.
It showed the picture of Tommy.
Really?
I didn't click it.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, okay. So you just read the headline?
Yeah.
Oh,
okay. Way to jump in.
But it showed the guy.
No.
No, I get. They look very similar. I know who you're. It wasn't him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It was like a Red Ranger from a couple seasons ago or something.
Yeah, those guys were like always at like conventions and stuff now too, right?
Because they make some dough.
Yeah, they make dough. Always at like WonderCon, Comic-Con, Kamikaze.
I see the Black Ranger there all the time.
Black Ranger there. He's
always there.
Time.
And
yeah.
then Billy too, right? Wasn't
Billy?
Billy. Yeah. I want to say the Black Ranger was in Brink. I think he was in Brink.
Was he the skater?
No. I think he was. What, I think he was
part of Val's team.
No, I think he was.
Is that him?
I don't think that's him.
I think it was another black guy.
I know.
I could. Why did I type in Blink 182? What the fuck? I don't know why I did that.
You typed in Brink 182.
Oh, I did. Huh? That's awesome. Alex is the best phone call ever. Hold on. I'm going to find out.
Alex is still on the line, by the way. Just leaving him hanging here.
Okay. Hold on. You guys.
I don't
this
think
awesome.
He was in it. No.
Yeah. Walter Emmanuel Jones. Oh, shit. Bitches. Woo. Yeah. He was in it.
He was
told
Boomer.
You. Yeah.
He's right. Mm-hmm. He's right.
Wait, he's the guy who was like trying to calm down the asshole guy, right?
Yeah, because like he was on the bad. Oh, yeah. God. That guy was the biggest douche.
He was.
He
yeah.
was.
What was
he has no idea
name?
What we're talking about.
Yeah, about
you never Brink?
Dude, hold on. Okay, right. Alex, bring. Are you? Right. Hold on. I'm gonna bring right. this up. Yeah. We are.
I think we've talked about this before.
I don't think we have. Okay. Even if we have,
I would think you would see Brink.
X-Blades. That was the name. Alex, X-Blades. Were you a big fan of the Disney Channel original movies?
That's a negative.
Yes. Alex, you have joined my side.
he was like four at the time.
I was more of a Nickelodeon kid.
Yes. Aww.
Okay, look, I was a Nickelodeon guy too, but I watched all the Disney Channel movies.
How much
all
TV
the
did Disney you watch?
All of them. Dude, the other night, they have them all on Amazon. I watched Phantom of the Megaplex the other night.
I've seen that one.
Dude, it's
I've,
such a
I've
great movie.
That
a
good
one.
I've seen that one.
Dude,
relax.
But,
yeah. I've seen Motocrossed.
That one's okay.
I think that's it. I think that's all I've seen.
Brink, Johnny Tsunami,
yeah.
Under Wraps. Smart House.
Halloween Town.
Halloween Town.
It's great.
Dude, watch Under Wraps. There's
Under Wraps is great for a
kids movie. There's some creepy, brutal horror stuff in there that's actually really, because they go to a movie theater to watch like scary movies, and like some dude like a knife gets stuck in the little fucking vent in the kitchen, and they get like, yeah, it's pretty dope.
Don't look under the bed.
Don't Look Under the Bed was fucking scary, dude.
Yes.
Did you not have a childhood, Cody?
I had a great childhood. I was outside having a good time with friends.
What did you have, friends? Yeah. Were you reading books?
We were outside. I was outside too, watching these shows, dude, on my tablet.
That was not possible back then.
I love all the Brink quotes. It's like, when you woke up this morning, did you say to yourself, I'm going to talk or I'm going to skate?
That was a quote. My favorite part in that movie was when Gabby falls down and he's like, and everyone's like, Gabby. And he's like, Gabby. And then he just skates off to her. Not high school.
Like, you know
Xenon.
You know what you got to do.
The 13th year.
The
Luck of the Irish.
Luck of the Irish.
Alley Cat Strikes. I can't believe you haven't seen that movie.
That's a good one.
It's about bowling,
guy.
Dude.
Oh, fuck yeah.
They call him Bowling right. Dude.
Yeah, they call him the Bowling Dude. Halloween Town 2.
Have I told you guys my plan?
Calabar's Revenge.
My only plan at work
Calabar.
Now is to start a
Calabar's
bowling
Calabar's Revenge. Oh, yeah. Are we going to start the bowling
Yeah,
game?
You're living close now, huh?
Yeah,
we're going to do it.
Horse Sense. Jumping Ship.
Was that with the three brothers?
The Pirates?
The Lawrence Brothers.
The Lawrence Brothers. The Color of Friendship. That movie was fucking dark.
It was pretty racial.
Yes, it was.
You Wish.
Oh, remember?
You Wish. Oh, God. But
true something with Shia LaBeouf when he played like a slow person.
Oh, yeah.
True Confessions.
Yeah, that was...
I couldn't do it. Which one was You Wish about?
You Wish was that this guy wished that his brother never existed, and that...
Dude, that one's fucking dark. Yeah. I remember that. Okay.
Oh, what about the one where... that his life is, like, much tougher when his little brother is gone?
That's really sad.
Yeah.
What about the one where he...
Alex, do you have anything else to talk about? Sorry, we're leaving you hanging. We'll leave you with one more question, then we'll go on a rant of all this stuff.
No, it's all good. I just wanted to say hi to you guys.
Hi.
Thank you for doing what you do.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it.
Always good talking to you.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it was nice to see you yesterday, and I hope to see you guys soon.
Absolutely, right, man. Take care, buddy. Thanks for dealing with
us. Bye.
Later, buddy.
Bye.
See you guys.
All right. So, about anyways, Lizzie McGuire.
That was a good one.
Oh, I love
it. But what was the one where like he created a person out of
The Other Me?
The Other Me. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The Other Me.
Yeah.
That was a good one. Joey Lawrence or one of the Lawrence brothers?
Andrew Lawrence, I think is
Andy Lawrence, maybe.
Somebody. Yeah.
Family in the Making Place.
Cody, did you have a TV when you grew up?
I had a TV and I watched Nickelodeon because that was a much better channel than the Disney Channel. I said it. Come at me.
Cheetah Girls.
Cheetah Girls. I saw Cheetah Girls.
The Proud Family movie. I never liked Proud Family.
I enjoyed the Proud Family. What did you say? Nickelodeon.
I watched stuff like All That and Don't Be Afraid of the Dark.
I watched those too.
Weren't movies though.
I didn't watch like TV movies, man.
I couldn't go to the movies. I watched movies at home.
I don't think I
Up, Up, and Away.
Full
Court
cool.
Miracle.
Well, I did watch the Kenan and Kel movie. I think it was Two Heads Are Better Than None.
Yes,
I want to say
that was scary stuff in that too.
That was a good one. That was a good one.
Dude, Good Burger's still good.
Good Burger's awesome.
It still holds up to me.
Yeah, it's good.
Oh, I'm hungry now.
What was the one? It was Frankie Muniz drives
Miracle on
Lane Two.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I always got confused. I was like, "Is this a sequel?" Because it was Miracle on Lane Two. Where's the first movie? Where is it at? Yeah, the brother was always mad at him for stuff. Yeah, why do you hate things, Cody?
I don't hate things. I just didn't watch the Disney Channel. I'm sorry.
I think what was great about it too is the fact that they had like holiday themed. I mean, like all the Halloween Disney
Poop
Channel.
Point. Which one? Remember the poof point?
I thought you said poop.
Taj Mahari.
That sounds like a movie I want to watch.
No? Nobody? No? Mm. No. Cheetah Girls 2?
But they had Halloween. Halloween Town for Halloween was good.
Yeah, but they always, like all their Halloween, all the Disney Channel Halloween movies were actually, like Under Wraps, Halloween Town, Halloween Town 2, like those were good. Like I felt like those movies that, it holds up, man. Yeah.
I haven't seen them in a while, but
it's fun.
I'm sure.
13th Year where he's a merman, not a mermaid.
That was a fun movie.
Johnny Tsunami is probably my favorite. Okay, Cody, what do you want to talk about?
Oh, I'm sorry, guys. No, you keep talking. I'm just taking a nap.
You know what we should do? We haven't done in a while.
What?
Let's have you do a pitch.
Oh, great. So I'm not fucking prepared.
No, okay. Not at all. You're right. You're a screenplay writer.
I can do the Pokemon part two if you guys want.
Yeah.
I could probably
So Ace,
I got to find it real
Cody,
quick. Give
Cody
me a second. Give me a few minutes
His first movie, a Pokemon first movie, and now he's setting up for the sequel.
Were you a Pokemon fan?
Yeah. I mean, is it a live action Pokemon? Okay.
I'm doing it like the Harry Potter route, where it's like there's gonna be like eight movies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And where he left off last time, you were about to go into Mount Moon, I believe.
Yeah, yeah. She, Red is my main character. She's a 16-year-old girl.
Yeah.
She beat Brock, who has been infamous for not allowing any trainers to pass him in like 5-10 years.
Yeah.
And she was able to beat him. Now she's going off to Mount Moon.
Nice.
And that's how the first movie ended.
Nice.
I still have to find the file. Give me a second, you guys. I'm going to find it. Give me like 10 seconds.
Be prepared for this.
Hold on now. Pokemon brainstorm. All right. And do you have the music, Brian? Do you have the instrumental music?
Yes, I do. God, are you ready to?
I think so.
I don't know. I want to.
Now, I haven't thought about this in like 3 weeks, so I may forget some things, but we'll see how this goes.
I want to go on your time. Are you telling me to go?
Start off with a hi-hat before we get into the song. Oh, he's taking a sip of his beer for the audio only listeners. All right,
what do you mean, sorry?
Are you ready? I'm gonna go. Yeah, I'm gonna go.
You ruined it. You want to do it over?
Just go. No, okay. All right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a little off. All right. Whatever. We can do it again.
So we pick up. Red is now taking off, going through route number 3, which, as you recall from the game, is the one that leads to Mount Moon, right? She's over here kicking ass, beating all these trainers. Even youngster Joey, who likes to wear shorts because they're comfortable and easy
fucking
to wear.
Fucking asshole.
So she goes up to Mount Moon, right? And it's this really weird area where there's, like, craters and shit inside, and weird stuff happens. Cell phone reception doesn't work. It's a really weird place.
They have cell phones.
Yeah, in there, she finds this little, like, fossil-type thing. She's like, oh, ugh. Now I know in the game you get them in Peter City. I don't give a shit. But she finds this fossil. She's like, oh, that's cool. I'm gonna keep that for later. She comes across a guy from this really mysterious guy. He has this, he's really weird. He's trying to steal shit. He's stealing Pokemon. He has a weird a big R across his fight. It's a guy from Team Rocket. Okay, someone from Team Rocket's there.
Jesse or James?
Yeah, no, neither. Different guy. We'll get to Jesse and James. Okay. Don't worry, I got plans here. So she's fighting him off. She finds a Clefairy. As you recall, it's this like really cool like Metrodomen Pokemon or whatever. She's able to fight him off with the help of Blue, who makes it through. She's like, I could have, you know, done that by myself. He's like, yeah, I know, whatever.
Like a nice Ray moment.
Yeah, exactly, whatever. Okay. And then she gets out of there. They fight off the trainer. They make it to Cerulean City. And now the trainers of this gym, it's not Misty. It's the two sisters from the show, if you recall. Mm-hmm. Remember this. Now, you can't do this unless you go through the Gauntlet, which, as you recall from the game, was a little like a bridge of trainers above Cerulean City. You got to go through that first to get certification. She does that. She goes to beats all the trainers, goes to the last guy, and if you go to there, you get to meet Bill, who is the Pokemon master or whatever, like the master of the land. And she learns very quickly that this is actually an imposter. This is a guy who is from Team Rocket as well. Team Rocket's like totally taken Cerulean City by hostage, essentially, is what's going on here.
Okay.
And because they're trying to get Red. They're trying to like kidnap her and steal our Pokemon. She's fucking good at this shit.
As you do.
So she gets all defeated or whatever. She gets her ass kicked, but she's able to escape. She goes off into the woods and she meets the actual Bill, who has gone into hiding or whatever, all this shit.
Billy.
And he takes her fossil and brings it to life or whatever. And it's not a Kabuto. It's not an Omnite. It's a fucking Aerodactyl, bitches.
Oh.
Remember that one? That's the coolest fucking one. She gets that. She goes back. She fights Team Rocket off and all that shit. And then she goes to Cerulean City, beats the gym trainers, goes off, and all that. And that's movie number two. And there's more that I totally forgot, but my laptop just went dark.
Oh, that's
so
okay.
I'm going to stop there, and I got criticized last time for going on for like 10 minutes. So I'm going to, that's the short version of that.
Who criticized that's you for going version. Too long?
A couple commenters.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Well, I mean, yeah, we got a show to do.
And that's that.
Ah, like it. Thank you.
Yep.
Thank you for that applause.
That's movie number two right there, guys.
Okay. It's cool, right. Man. Mm-hmm. Have you ever thought about who would be in these movies? Who do you
like
cast?
Actors?
Yeah.
No, I haven't thought about
no?
that.
No? You don't do the, like, you don't like.
No, because that never comes, that almost rarely ever comes true. Like for screenwriters.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Are there a lot of screenwriters that like write like that? Like this is meant for this
person?
Yeah,
and sometimes it works out, but most of the time it doesn't. Huh. Yeah.
Someone talking about sneak.
What the hell is that?
Oh, fuck. I forgot a cool part of that. Load up the music again. Load it up.
Okay, go.
There's one part I forgot to mention.
Okay.
What the fuck was that?
That was the end of the song. Come on.
Come on.
Because I stopped as you...
I stopped.
I forgot this part because the computer went down. It's a really important part that paves the way for future videos.
Okay.
So, as you recall...
It's Ruined City. As my mic goes down. My mic is down.
Brian.
Brian, what is going on? What are you doing?
He's trying to...
You're ruining my pitch here.
Okay, go ahead.
So she, as soon as she gets into Cerulean City, she walks up to the unknown dungeon, if you recall, the little cave up there, and she has this weird, like, psychic attack, and she blacks out.
Okay.
She wakes up, and that's explained later on.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I got for that part. I forgot to mention that earlier. But yeah,
oh, shit.
Yeah.
There you go.
That's a very important part in this saga. That's
okay.
Explained.
Your mic is off. Jesus.
Will you get
your mic is
together?
Still off.
All right. Are you good?
No, I'm good.
You good now?
Yeah. That was worth starting the music
yeah,
over?
Yeah, I had to do that.
It was worth it.
Yeah. I told you it was one thing I forgot.
Yeah.
I told you that.
Brian, did you ever play Pokemon? Or
no.
You never? Oh. Oof.
Why do you hate things, Brian?
Yeah.
Why do you hate things?
I like Pokemon Stadium and Pokemon Snap, and that's it.
Pokemon Stadium
was
cool
shit.
For a minute.
Ooh.
But Pokemon Snap is
did you forget something else, Cody?
Yeah, I forgot a bunch of stuff. It's fine. I don't want to do it.
Okay.
Yeah. Damn it.
We'll get to the third one. We'll get to the third one. We'll get to the third one eventually. This is gonna happen, dude. We're gonna make this.
We're gonna make all of it.
This should be our graphic novel. Might as well.
Oh, sure, fuck it.
You know how to draw?
There's no copyright infringement there.
Ah, shit. He doesn't know how to draw.
Fuck him. Damn it.
We don't have to sell it. We just do it for ourselves.
Okay, because that's cheap.
Yeah,
okay. I'm sorry. I'm being cynical.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, okay.
Anyway,
yeah, I like that a lot, man.
Yeah.
Out there. Okay. Yeah. Okay. I want to see it. Okay. I want to see it. Write a book on it.
Write a book?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's really hard.
Okay.
Don't do it.
All right. Ace, how you doing?
Good, man.
Yeah?
Do you ever watch those Hollywood Reporter roundtable discussions?
Oh, yeah. I watched one from a couple.
Yeah.
I didn't watch any of the newer ones. I didn't watch
the screenwriter one was really interesting.
Yeah.
They had Taylor Sheridan on, and they had a few other writers on. And
what did Taylor write?
Hell or High Water.
Ooh, okay. I have not seen it, but I hear good
it's
things.
Great.
Oh, I can't wait for you
it's
to
great.
Shit on it.
And he wrote...
I'm sure I would love it.
For what movie again? Sorry.
Hell or High Water.
Hell or High Water and Sicario. He wrote he wrote Sicario, and he's doing his new movie.
Yeah,
I forget what it's called. White River or Wind River? Wind River.
Mm-hmm.
Which was premiered at Sundance, and it got a lot of good word.
Okay.
But he's definitely an interesting writer that...
he did a lot of Sons of Anarchy.
Yeah.
Oh, no, he was an actor in Sons of Anarchy.
Yeah.
I'm an actor.
I saw the round table with Donald Glover, Jon Favreau, Damien Chazelle.
That one was interesting.
Lin-Manuel Miranda.
Yeah.
That was a good one. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
and the lady who wrote that HBO series. I forgot her name.
I forget her name as well. But she's great.
They just talked about like the culture and like how everything develops and evolves and like how
because
they stay ahead of the curve.
She basically created like a YouTube series and basically made that into an HBO show, which is like kind of like our dreams basically.
Yeah.
I mean, if we're like a young person who's like 25 years old,
like, audience of none.
Make like a YouTube series and eventually HBO's like, I like that.
Yeah,
you can pitch that as a show, then make an HBO show.
Yeah. Like Broad City was a YouTube show.
Broad City is another example.
Was it really?
Yeah,
that's cool.
They did shorts and stuff, and then they got picked up, and it's like, whoa.
That, cool. Yeah, kind of showing like it's possible. Same with Donald, because Donald started like in the online world.
He started as like a comedy troupe. Yeah. And Derek Comedy. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Derek Comedy. It was funny, man.
Yeah, I've never seen a few like, videos. They still have like...
Their videos
it's,
up,
it's,
yeah.
It's pretty like controversial because they have the N-word on it.
Oh yeah,
the one where like
I don't see how it's controversial, but yeah, I totally.
They're at a spelling bee and they have to
it's
spell.
So
it.
Funny. That one's so funny.
Yeah.
But yeah, so those roundtables are great.
Yeah, those I love those ones a lot.
I love those, and they're super freaking long, and I sit down and watch them all the time.
I use a lot of those for inspiration for because at my old job we were doing interviews with like because I worked in nails and stuff, and there's like nail. Educators and stuff like that, and we wanted to do this and don't spill it and we wanted to do that same kind of thing where they're just all sitting around in a circle with like cool things in the background where you can just get all different perspectives of them, and the way they shoot those and put those things together is pretty damn cool.
Yeah The actor one was super cool too because they had Jeff Bridges and Andrew Garfield and all them, so that was a lot of fun.
Yeah. No,
were they just like, we're acting. We're actors.
No,
we're
they actually told like a really, like Jeff Bridges told some great stories, man. Everyone was freaking fascinated by him when he was kind of going off into his stories and all that. And he told a great story about Jon Favreau in Iron Man and how he, you know, kind of the whole concept of like the superhero world and all that. And he kind of explained the balance between working with the Marvel studio and trying to make your own original film at the same time. And there was a lot of push and pull between John, but he was still able to take all their notes and at the same time make the movie he wanted to make.
I can imagine that too. I can imagine because that movie was so early on, they probably didn't have to deal with it as much because of how standalone that movie is in comparison to now.
And it's funny because you would think that, but yet as Jeff is telling the story, he's like, nah, dude, Marvel was like straight up giving notes like every day and writing stuff on the spot, and John basically had to change shoots and stuff on the spot. And it's crazy how he basically says that, but the great thing about Jon Favreau is the fact he could take all these Marvel notes and still put his own spin on it and still make it a good movie.
Unlike, he did that better with the first Iron Man than he did the second one.
Absolutely.
But
But it's great to hear about that because it's almost like we always wonder, how do these directors work with the Marvel studio when it's a system that you're basically being placed into?
I like to think about it too, because like what parts in that first Iron Man were so setting up for other things other than S.H.I.E.L.D., you know?
I mean, honestly though, the entire tone of that movie.
If you're thinking about the tone, yeah.
The tone has not changed since 2008. If you think about it, Iron Man tone is...
Iron Man's one of the more serious ones too.
Yeah, and yet it has that balance between drama and comedy, like every Marvel movie. Some more than others, but it still has that same formula that is kept throughout all the MCU movies.
What would you guys say the darkest MCU movie is?
Ooh.
Winter Soldier?
Civil War.
Civil War gets pretty dark
towards
the end.
It does. But see, that's tonally though, that movie switches it up so fast. Because when they go to the airport scene, it almost doesn't fit.
It's just fun.
The end, I think I've said this before, but the end scene in Civil War is miles better than the airport scene.
Oh no, it is. Absolutely.
It means so much more.
It's a lot more emotional.
You feel way more emotion with it and you care so much more. Because in the airport scene, they're not trying to kill each other.
Right.
And at the end, it genuinely feels like fuck you, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like,
when Tony Stark and Captain America
when they're
just
going
like
at
beating
it.
Each other.
Yeah, they're fucking furious. I think it's so much better.
The moment that Iron Man finds out that Bucky killed his parents, I think that's probably the darkest moment in the MCU we've gotten so far. But you know what's my thing? That's the thing for the MCU movies that has always been my criticism, is the fact that I feel like they're so light and fluffy that even their darkest moment is like, at the end, Captain America is still like, hey, man, I got your back. Yeah. I love you, brother. And it's like, well, I didn't want that. I didn't want them to be like, I got you, brother. I wanted them to be
at each
other's throats till the end of the movie. And they kind of weren't.
Yeah.
Which it's like PG at best.
Yes.
Like,
and that's why
that R.
That's why Civil War didn't hit what I wanted it to hit, and that's why I put Doctor Strange above it in my top 10 of the year, because for me it was like, that's such a good movie, but man, I wanted it to hurt me, you know, at the bottom of my soul, and it kind of didn't, because at the end they're like, dude, you're cool.
So I mean, it's just like at the end of the day, they have to, you know, they're going to be together in Infinity War, so it's like they got to...
I felt like the MCU producers and the creators were kind of afraid to go there. They were afraid, oh, we don't want the audiences and the children to think that Captain America and Iron Man aren't friends anymore.
That's what disappointed me about Avengers Age of Ultron is how at the very... Because I love that movie. I really do love that movie. I love that movie a lot. It gets a really bad rep, but it's really freaking good time to watch that movie.
Yeah.
And then just at the very end of the film, it's like they're all fine. And I thought, you know, if they were going to lead up to Civil War, they'd kind of be at each other's throats. You get a little bit of that, but it's more or less the same movie as the first one, except you just get more action.
Yeah. I was going to say that Age of Ultron to me is still like the same thing as Avengers, except more jokes and more action.
Yeah. Which was exactly because I like the first Avengers. Yeah. I like it a lot. I love the buildup and all that too, but I think it was a little overhyped.
Yeah.
But it's still a really great movie. And then when I saw Age of Ultron, I was like, this is exactly what I wanted with the first movie. It's just, you know, we don't need this setup anymore. They are already established. It's goofy as shit.
Yeah.
And that's what I loved about it. I want the over-the-top zaniness of all it. Not all of these movies have to be incredibly dark. Have your dark moments and then get out of there.
But I feel it was really weak. The villain was really weak. It's like, okay, we created him and now we have to beat him. It's like, it was like super... fast like that, and it wasn't really set up well.
I like Ultron as a villain, but I just wish they wouldn't fight an army every single movie.
Yep.
Yeah.
I wish they would have just like, and as going back and rewatching that movie, I realized like, oh, they actually fight Ultron. Like each main character kind of fights him throughout the movie. Like Iron Man throws it down with him. They all throw it down with him at the very beginning. Then Iron Man throws it down with him at one point. Thor does. Vision does at one point. Captain America throws it down. Like they all kind of fight
their moments.
But I wish like at the end of the movie it was just Ultron fighting all of them off. Like that would have been really cool. And if he was gonna have an army, not like billions, you know, he had just a few here and there. Or at least not try to destroy the world. I wish he would have done what like the Joker did and just try to break, like, you know, what they were trying to do is break them apart. Yeah. I wish that was the whole goal. You know, not try to destroy the world, but to destroy the Avengers, you know what I mean? So
that's why I felt like Civil War did that well.
It did.
Split them up well. I think that was well done.
Yeah.
But I mean, to go to your point about how making all these movies dark, but I feel like MCU, none of them are dark.
Though. No, they really aren't. Like you said, the darkest thing that happens in Civil War is
a moment.
Is a moment in that film. But you know, that's why they're comic book movies at the end of the day. Yeah. You know,
and at the end of the day, they're trying to appeal to kids as well. And
they are. It's a good balance. It's a good balance between the two. Like I love Logan, but no Marvel movie in the MCU needs to be rated R.
I agree.
Maybe like Punisher, but that's Netflix, so that's like a different thing, and it's not necessarily tied back into the MCU that much. So it's like you can get away with that, but you know,
I feel like everything. See, when people say it's a comic book, it's a comic book. I feel like that sometimes is a cop out because that's why I like Marvel Netflix, because if you read the Daredevil comics, they are bloody and they are violent and they are vicious. If you read the Punisher comics, they are bloody, violent, and vicious. But it's a comic book movie. Why is it got to be all dark? Because the comic book in itself is dark, and the character has a very dark story. So that's why you make a dark movie. Everyone who complains about that just gets me upset because they're like, everything's dark now. Yeah. It's like, the character is supposed to be dark. Yeah. He's supposed to be violent.
I think there's some comic book character. Like I said, I haven't read a whole lot of the comic books, but I feel like a lot of the MCU characters aren't part of the darkness. Like Punisher, Daredevil makes sense.
Punisher, Daredevil.
You can go those kind of ways. I've read some stuff on them. But, like, I know Captain America is like, oh, I'm Captain America. Like, you know, he has to be.
You can't have a dark Thor movie.
No. Like Thor is goofy as shit.
Yeah.
That's why, like, the newest one is the most anticipated one, even more so than Avengers Age of Infinity War. I'm more excited for that because
I'm pumped for
a lot of people
Ragnarok.
Didn't like Thor the Dark World. Everyone hates that fucking movie. I love that movie so much.
Thor is my favorite character of the MCU.
Oh, okay.
I've said that many, 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 many times.
Do you like the first Thor?
I love the first Thor.
Do you like
the first Thor?
You like the first Thor?
Yeah.
I thought the first Thor is kind of just.
I love the first Thor.
Than the second one.
Yeah.
I love both Thors, but that's just because I love the character.
Like
Thor.
Kenneth Branagh's, like.
Yeah.
Dutch shots, Dutch angles, and like every.
Yeah, it's really weird that Kenneth Branagh is some Shakespeare actor.
No, that makes sense though. It makes sense though.
That he directed Thor?
Yeah, because Thor is supposed to be kind of like Shakespearean a little bit.
In a sense, he's right.
But this guy's doing Hamlet, and I don't know if he did like Macbeth or something.
He did do Macbeth. Oh, King Henry?
I
don't know.
He
did either King Henry or Macbeth. He did one of those. But it makes sense if they're going for that tone. It's like.
Yes.
Like. What doesn't make sense are the directors, the Russo brothers, like, they're going to do Captain America.
Henry V.
There you go.
And Hamlet.
But he didn't do Macbeth?
That's what I said.
Hold on. That's as an actor. He directed
Hamlet and wrote.
No, he did. He directed both.
Okay.
Nice.
But it's like, you hear like the Russo brothers, they're doing a political thriller for Captain. That doesn't make sense. And then they do it. You're like, oh, shit. Okay. All right. Right on. You know, Joe Johnston doing Captain America. Yeah, I can see that. They've always had kind of good fits.
That first movie's really good, guys.
Captain America?
Yeah, the first Captain America.
Oh, I like it a lot.
I love it a lot.
I like the movie a lot.
If you go back and rewatch it, I think it's
probably
it's
my least favorite.
I think they brush over. they brush over.
I was going to say it's my least favorite Marvel movie.
I think they brush over a lot of his fighting scenes. So
that's on TV, I watch it every single time. Mm-hmm. Honestly.
I love the build up to him. I love the build up to him for sure.
For me, I don't know. Just to me, I feel like I was like, oh, Captain America. What the Russos did with Captain America was actually make him cool and make him like, I like this character. Because in the first movie, I was like, I don't know if I like this guy.
I like Red Skull as a villain.
How do you not like him? He's so sympathetic.
You know, I like him, but I'm not like invested in
him. I see what you mean.
Okay. Yeah, but when the Russos did their movie, I was like, oh.
I thought you meant like he was a dick. I'm like, hold on, he's the nicest person in the world.
Yeah,
I think one of the coolest moments of seeing Winter Soldier in theaters is, most people know like who this Winter Soldier is. It's a little pop culture-y in a sense. I mean, like, not everyone knows who it is, but when watching that movie and they made that reveal about Bucky and the Winter Soldier, a lot of people in the audience were like, they didn't know? That's cool. Yeah. That's really cool. Gives me chills thinking about that. That's really cool.
I've had moments like that where, because we're all in kind of the movie universe, so we kind of hear all the news that this person's been cast and this person's the villain. But when we go into theater, we assume everyone else knows as well. Mm-hmm. And sometimes they don't. And it's always kind of fun seeing moments that we've seen and we've heard about in trailers and stuff.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, and you're like, dude, this was in the trailer.
It's very important to be cautious of what you're saying, especially with comic books. And like, you know, not a lot of people know who the Winter Soldier is. So, and it's nice to see, like, even though that, you know, that's the moment. But it's a nice little buildup that they have to it. You know, it's respectful to the audience members. They're not making it super obvious or anything like that. So, nice little nod.
Did you guys know Kenneth Branagh narrated Walking with Dinosaurs?
No.
But it sounds
the more you know.
Did you also know that he was in Wild Wild West?
Yes, he was. Mm-hmm. Yeah. He was in...
Or is that his name?
Oh, no, yeah, you're right. He was the main villain.
He was the guy in the wheelchair.
Was he?
Yeah, Kenneth Branagh.
Oh, my God.
I'd like to give you a standing ovation.
Yeah.
That was Kenneth Branagh.
Let me give you a hand.
Holy fuck. Yeah. You guys remember The Road to El Dorado?
No.
Yeah.
The Disney movie? Or no, it's DreamWorks.
DreamWorks. Yeah, wow. I was going to say that's not Disney.
That's actually okay.
The Elton John song? Yeah.
Okay.
I'm over here on Kenneth Branagh's filmography here, guys.
He's a pretty good actor.
He's made some stuff.
Oh, dude. Was he Harry Potter?
Oh yeah, he was a professor something.
And the second one, Chamber of Secrets.
Professor
Lockhart or something.
Lockhart.
Is that his
Gilderoy,
name?
Gilderoy
Lockhart. Yes. Right. He's the best part of that movie.
He's so.
I'll look it up myself, but I'm sure he was nominated for Oscars for the Hamlet.
Oh, give me a second.
Probably.
You don't have to.
Hold on, Hamlet.
Hamlet's a great story. We have a caller.
The film received 4 Academy Award nominations: Best Art Direction, Best Costume Design, Best Original Score, and Best Writing. Yeah, it looks like he was not nominated.
Nothing for him.
This is according to Wikipedia, so it could be very
wrong. Guess the story wasn't so great then, huh?
The Shakespeare story itself is an amazing story.
Oh, you read?
Yeah.
Oh, besides biographies?
No? Read autobiographies?
Yeah, it didn't win any Oscars. He was nominated for 4, but didn't win any.
Okay.
You don't believe me, do you? You're looking it up?
I'm looking at myself, okay. Cody.
I'm over here. You said Hamlet, right? Not Henry V?
Yeah, no, but I'm asking if he was nominated for anything.
He was nominated for Best Writing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, adapted screenplay. He got a nomination for.
We have a caller on the line. You guys want to talk to him?
Want to talk about Kenneth Branagh?
Him or her?
Him.
Him or her?
What do you mean?
Him or her?
I said him.
Do you know it's a man?
Yeah, because this guy's been tweeting at me all day.
Okay, fair enough.
All righty. Caller, you're on the line. You're on the Wanger Show. Who do we got? I hope it's a woman. Just a fucking.
This is actually Brian in Miami.
Brian Fernandez, what's up, buddy? What's up? How you doing, man?
Yes, and Beardo, yes, it is me tweeting at you, and yes, it is. Damn you, Brian.
So yeah.
Must know who it is. That's my Twitter handle.
There you go.
Yeah.
What would you like to talk about?
Well, let me just say, fuck. Thank God I get to call in.
Yeah, buddy. I see your tweet here. I'm sorry.
Tried to call. Holy crap.
Oh,
no, man. I could take a screen grab of like my how many times I've tried to call in.
And always take screenshots.
72, 73. Mm. 73 times.
Wow.
Holy crap. And this is 74.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. Well, congratulations. You've done it. What would you like to talk about today, Brian?
Okay. I I have to say this. Sorry, Mark Ellis, but it's not going to make $200 million.
Ah, Beauty and the Beast. Oh, yeah, it got close, man. It got close. I was really hoping it would.
That would be very funny.
It would be so funny if
he was very, very close. Oh. He wasn't too far. If he would have set like 180,
then
maybe he would have had a even closer shot, but... Yeah, he's going to have to wear a Predator costume throughout the whole show.
He didn't wear it the whole time?
I think so.
With the mask?
I hope
with the mask. That is so funny.
But
the audio is probably going to sound terrible.
If it's with the mask, then that'll be gold right there.
Yeah. Oh, I already got the thumbnail. He's taking the picture in the Predator mask for the thumbnail. For sure. Amazing.
We should just put a little lava underneath so he can still talk.
Yeah we could. Yeah, we absolutely could.
Yeah, oh, to be fair, Sunday's actual numbers haven't come in yet, but we'll see. We'll see.
Make sure you have a flap so that way he can like use the bathroom if he needs to. So,
that is true. Yeah. Just
keep going.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah. All right, Brian. Well, do you want to ask us one more thing before we let you go?
Yes. One more thing, guys. I saw the behind the scenes and I love Job for a Cowboy.
Oh, yeah. That's funny. Yeah. That was kind of like a last minute thing that we were hoping to do.
Let's change up the music.
Up the music a little bit, and you didn't see it.
Okay. So, is there any other metal bands that you love listening to besides Job for a Cowboy?
Oh yeah, I wasn't even actually a big Job for a Cowboy fan. You guys can take a minute to
yeah. You guys want to? You guys want to do a lap? You want to run around?
I wasn't like the biggest Job for a Cowboy fan. I just remember that song. Like that was like a go to song a lot of the time, but. You know, we dabbled in some other metal songs for Breath of the Future. I don't want to give away because we're probably just going to end up using different metal songs for each segment because I think it's too good. But, I grew up listening to Black Dahlia Murder. I listened to Killswitch Engage. Not so much like death metal as opposed to just,
Simple Plan.
I did not listen to Simple. But okay. I have a variety. Yellow Card.
Newfound Glory.
I like Yellow Card. Newfound Glory is pretty good. Yeah. I like Blink-182, obviously.
Classic metal.
Yeah. But I was more for the metal core than the actual like death metal. But I do love some demonic shit.
Do you listen to like Skillet? Do you listen to Skillet?
I did not. No, I had a buddy that I played baseball with that I was kind of obsessed with them. But not the biggest fan of them. But Slipknot, I love
The Fray,
System of a Down.
The Fray
is a
great metal.
I follow 666 people on Twitter for a reason. So.
Lumineers.
Yeah, Lumineers going. Yeah.
Yeah. What about you? What would you say your favorite?
No wonder they call you the devil.
Yeah. What would you say your favorite metal band is?
My two favorite metal bands are Slipknot and
Bob Dylan.
Black Dahlia Murder.
Limp Bizkit.
Black Dahlia Murder is the shit, man. I saw them.
I've listened to Black Dahlia Murder since they started.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I've listened to Skillet and Metallica as well. So
Nickelback.
I've listened to like so many friggin' metal bands, dude.
Yep. I'm seeing Metallica, Avenged Sevenfold, and Gojira in July. So I'm very excited about that.
Smash Mouth.
Third Eye Blind.
I cannot wait to see Metallica here in Miami. That is going to be a badass concert. Last time that I went to go see them was in Montreal, Canada. This was like 3-4 years ago. And holy crap, they were awesome.
Good stuff, man.
98
Degrees. Oh, bro, in Canada, watching freaking Metallica, it was just like at
that must
first,
be the that must be the was, nicest at mosh pit first, in the world. Just like,
sorry,
you okay? Sorry, sorry about that.
At first, it was hell because with all the mosh pits. But then after that, like I was like, okay, let me just move back a bit. Let me move away from the pit. But then when you try to move away, you're just like getting in. You're just getting in it either way, and you're just like. Lordy.
All righty, man. Yeah. Well, thank you so much, man.
Thank you, Brian.
I appreciate that, man. Fellow metalhead out there, I'm glad to see. I'm glad to actually see a lot of people like picking up on the metal during the show, which was actually pretty cool.
A lot of people caught that.
A lot of people caught that, which is fucking nice.
Can I make a song suggestion for future Breath of the Future?
Absolutely.
Anything Suicide Silence.
Yeah, we could do some
Suicide Silence.
There's a couple good Suicide Silence songs that we can do. Not their new stuff. Their new stuff is fucking terrible.
I think the new stuff is pretty okay, but their old stuff is god right there.
For sure.
That is
for sure, bro.
And another one is who was who was I listening to today as well as working out? Oh, Lamb of God.
Lamb of God's good.
I used to listen to some Lamb of God.
Lamb of God's good. Yeah. Yeah, we could do some Lamb of God.
Down, you've got something to die for.
I feel like we just summoned a demon here in the center of the room.
Whoa!
All right, Brian. We'll definitely get some Lamb of God up there.
Thank you, Brian.
Oh, there you go. Whoa. There it is. Oh, Reagan? Wow. Am I talking to Reagan?
Oh, Jesus.
Thanks, buddy. We appreciate the call, man. We'll talk to you next time, buddy.
Wang is for life.
Yeah, Wang buddy. Wang is for life. Wang it on. All righty. You guys don't like metal, huh? What the fuck?
Avril Lavigne?
Avril Lavigne? Jeez. Wasn't she married to the Sum 41 singer?
Sum 41.
Michelle Branch. What's it going?
Three Doors Down.
Three Doors Down.
Ugh. Nah,
which one's Michelle Branch?
Because you're everywhere.
I was going to say, which one's Making My Way Downtown?
Oh, that's... I actually don't know that one. Oh,
it's
Creed.
Yeah, that one.
And I need you.
The song I've had stuck in my head. I pulled this off.
It's called Over the... And now I
do you guys remember the commercials for Ring Pop?
Oh, Vanessa something, right?
Oh,
Vanessa Carlton.
Yes.
Vanessa Carlton.
Yes.
Oh!
If I make one contribution to the Wanger Show, it's this song.
Okay. I was going to say. Get it out of there.
Oh, man.
Music, man.
Cool. Yeah,
fucking music. You guys remember the commercials for Ring Pops?
No.
Why do you bring that up?
Because I had it queued up.
Copyright.
You can wear a ring around your finger, ring pop. I love the way your ring looks.
Oh.
That's the way my ring tastes.
Oh. What the fuck? I love it how it fits in my mouth.
I got dark.
Ring pop.
Ring pop.
Ring pop. It's a lollipop.
Jesus Christ. All right, and on that note,
I wish this had jingles like that.
I think it's I commission commercials like that. Man.
I think that's
I miss that
show. Oh yeah, where they're just completely over the top. Yeah. Yeah. But on that note, I think that's a perfect.
I had that queued up the whole show.
You did. You did.
That's amazing. All right.
Well, thanks for that.
Yeah, no problem. It's my contribution today.
That about does it for us on here on the Wanger Show. Mm-hmm. Ace, thanks for coming on.
Oh,
man.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming on, the Wangers.
Did you have a good time?
Appreciate it.
I did, yeah. It was a lot of fun.
Cool, man.
We got nothing done, did we? We accomplished nothing.
I kind of like that, though.
Yeah, it's fun, huh?
But sometimes you just got to turn on the mics, talk about shit. Yeah. Number one, number two channel, and SK Plus channel, whatever the fuck. I mean, who gives a fuck, man? Just have fun. You just have fun doing your thing,
man. I mean,
man.
Who gives a fuck, man?
Yeah, who give a fuck? I don't know why I'm talking like that, but I don't want to do it before.
We watched Waterboy last week.
Watched Waterboy.
Yeah.
Ace, tell the good people on the internet, the interwebs where they can find you, what stuff you got going on.
Yeah, you can find me on Twitter and Instagram at Squad Leader Ace.
There you go.
Brian,
where can they find you on the social media world?
Schmo's Beardo.
Okay.
Cool. And my Don't Be a Beardo podcast. I interviewed Makuga for the next episode.
Which will be coming out tomorrow.
That'll be tomorrow.
Yes, because it airs on Mondays. Yes.
Yep. It had to be cut short, but I hope to get him back again.
Okay. Oh. Yeah. Alrighty. All right. So be sure to check that out. Cody, where can the good people find you on the internet?
Find me on Twitter at The Real Cody Hall. And behind the scenes at Schmoes No and Collider and other fun thing. Behind the scenes.
Yeah.
that's where you can find me.
Okay. And then you can find me on Twitter at Copser15. You can find me on the live show every single Wednesday, Schmoes No at Schmoes No, youtube.com/Schmoes No, live, 7 to 9 p.m. PST.
Are you from Schmoes No?
I'm from Schmoes No. Yeah, okay. From Schmoes No. Okay. We got this Friday. And then, so be sure to find us there. Got a lot of fun stuff. I don't know what's going on this week, because I never do, but I'm sure a lot of people will be drunk, and I'm sure Brett will be yelling at some people that are just
yell away, Brett.
Yell away. I approve everything that Brett does. It's so good. And then also, be sure to leave a comment on this video. Give the video a like if you liked it. And once again, we will be giving away another Wanger shirt on this episode. The giveaway winner, I can't remember his name, but I said your name at the beginning of the show. You should have been watching. And maybe
what if he wasn't? He's like, oh fuck, I didn't watch the beginning
of
the show.
He just tuned into the last 10 seconds of the show. Yeah. Yeah. But be sure to contact me on Twitter at Copser15. I'll get you that shirt. And again, leave a funny comment down below. And, we laugh at some pretty stupid shit. So, do that. So here we go with a hi-hat. That was a little fucking early, but whatever.
Well, you did the hi-hat way too early. The hi-hat's in the song.
That's true.
You're doing a double hi-hat at this point.
Well, you got to do...
You're saying go... Ch-ch-ch, bah,
yeah. Yeah.
It's just a double hi-hat.
Okay, then we'll... The next time we'll do the sticks, like...
I'm saying the song doesn't really need it because there's the hi-hat in the song. There's already a countdown in
there. How are they know again, how to start the song?
Be like, all right, fucking whatever. It's, you know, in the beginning, it's just the guitar, I think. So you, whenever the guitar is
No,
starts.
It's all of them.
Oh, it's all of them?
It's all of them.
Okay, I should probably know the song that we're playing for our show.
Come on, man.
Anyway.
Jesus. All
right. Don't smoke crack. Don't.
That's a Waterboy soundbite. Where the hell was that?
That's awesome.
We listened to the whole thing, Ace. Why are you taking your headphones off?
Put your damn headphones back on.
Put them back on. Put them back on.
He's like, I want to go home.
Don't you dare take your headphones off. Jesus Christ. All right, you can take
That's
them off.
That's amazing.
Now you can take them off.
That's great, dude.
Smoke crack.
Yep.